Tonight from Melcher Gym on the campus of the Kincaid School in Houston, Texas, it's the FoxSportsHouston.com Game of the Week. Tonight featuring a Southwest Preparatory Conference matchup for first place in the South Division between the Episcopal Knights and the Kincaid Falcons. And along with Joe Price tonight, I'm Lonnie King, and we're happy to have you along for the ride here on FoxSportsHouston.com. And Joe, a lot of people don't know about the SPC in the area. They're used to the UIL and even a little bit familiar with Taps, but there's going to be some good basketball played here tonight.
I tell you what, you can feel it intensely when you walk in the gym with this crowd, and I'm sure they've been playing before crowds of 2,000 and 3,000 all year. But this is my first time being here, and I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, we expect an exciting game. Both these teams are 6-0 in the conference this year. Very good out of conference as well this season. The Episcopal Knights, under first-year head coach Kyle Maneri, have really taken off. They are 27-3 coming into this one. And I guess if you've got to be a first-year head coach at a program, you want to come into a situation where you're going to go 27-3.
That's exactly right. You know, you played 30 games, won 27 out of 30. Evidently, you got to be getting better this late in the year. This is the time of the year that you want to be gelling anyway, late this season.
But he goes up against a squad from Kincaid under Scott Zimmerman that comes in with 20 wins as well, 20-7 coming into the final regular season game of the year. And Coach Zimmerman's squad has been led by a trio of players who are underclassmen. And if he's got any thing besides the great season he's having to look forward to, it's the fact that he's going to have these kids back next year.
Exactly right. You know, you can't go wrong with having experience. You got guys in your program 2 or 3 years. By the time they're seniors, you just let them take over.
It's going to be an electric atmosphere here at the gym tonight, Melcher Gym on the campus of Kincaid. And when we come back, we'll visit with both the head coaches, Scott Zimmerman from Kincaid and Kyle Maneri from Episcopal, then have all the action for you from first tip to the final buzzer right here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Facility, then you need to talk to the folks at Fabenco, the world's leading manufacturer of industrial self-closing safety gates located right here in Houston, Texas. They offer a full range of OSHA-required safety gates that fit unprotected openings up to 60 inches on ladders, platforms, stairs, and mezzanines. They can also design custom safety gates for any special needs you may have. So keep your people safe and your facility OSHA compliant. Call Fabenco today at 713-686-6620 or visit their website at safetygate.com.
Back on the pregame show, and we're joined now by the head coach of the Kincaid Falcons, Scott Zimmerman, stops by for a visit. Coach, first of all, thanks for having us in tonight. This looks like it's going to be a fun atmosphere for a big game.
Well, I think it's going to be a fun night for our conference. I think both schools are having great years in basketball. I'm excited for the fans. I'm excited for both schools. It's going to be a great game. It's going to be a good night.
Let's talk a little bit about your team. You come into this one 20-7 overall, 6-0 in the SPC South. And for the folks that may not know, that Southwest Preparatory Conference, talk about how you've gotten to this point in the season for this big game with Episcopal.
You know, we've got a good group of seniors mixed with a pretty talented group of sophomores and juniors. I think we were working on our chemistry early in the year. We had a tough schedule, played a lot of good schools, quality schools. Really got challenged and learned what we needed to work on. And as the year's gone on, our chemistry has gotten better and better. Our practices have been real sharp. The guys' enthusiasm for each other and for the game has really kind of risen as we've gone on. And it's coming together right now. They're having a lot of fun, and it's been good to be around.
And I guess it kind of proves an old coaching adage that really is true. You'd rather be very good at the end than very good at the beginning.
Well, I think you set goals as a coaching staff at the beginning of the year to be playing your best basketball when conference time comes around and your end of the year tournament comes around. And I think we're fortunate. I think we're playing our best basketball right now.
Now, for the folks that aren't familiar with SPC basketball, a road trip for you sometimes can be a little bit different than a road trip for a public school in the area.
Yeah, we actually have two schools up in Oklahoma, but we go to Fort Worth, Dallas. We have two South Zone conference opponents that are in Austin. So we do. We travel. We don't do it as much. Some of them come down to Houston to play us, but we do travel quite a bit when we go, yeah.
and you've got a big three that's really kind of led your team all season long.
Yeah. We have two sophomore forwards, Jeff Roberson and Maven Saunders. Both of them are great inside-out guys. They're hard to guard. They balance the floor. You got to guard one on one side and be worried about the other on the other side. And then we've got a couple of guards that have really been doing well. Larry Wilkins is a junior, been shooting the ball real well for us and is really great defensively. And then Thomas Dillon, our sophomore point guard, is really coming on right now and playing good basketball as well.
And you talk about sophomores and juniors. I guess if there's one thing to take heart in, it's not only are they good now, but you've got them in the future.
Yeah, and I give a lot of credit to them. They're very great athletes. They're great kids. They work hard. But I also give credit to our seniors and our other juniors that have taught them and really gotten them involved in our program, made them feel involved and like they're a part of something with them. And so I think it's a team thing. It's not just that they're talented. I think everybody around them has really included them and made them feel a part of things.
Well, talk about your opponent tonight. Episcopal comes in. They're a very good team as well. In fact, tied with you at the top of the South standings. What do you know and what do you expect to see?
They're very long and they're very athletic. I think our young guards are pretty special, but their young guards are a little bit longer than ours. And so, they pressure out a lot defensively and they force you to do some different things and take you out of your comfort zone. If our guys can pass the ball well, if we can run good offense, I feel real good about our chances. But if they disrupt us and kind of throw us off our rhythm, we're going to have to dig a little bit deeper tonight. But they're very talented. They're very deep. They're tall. They've got a couple of big guys that challenge shots real well. We're going to have to be locked in. We're going to need to play very well together, not individually, if we want to have a chance to win this.
Good luck to you. Thanks for having us out.
Thank you, Lonnie. It's a privilege. Thank you.
Scott Zimmerman, the head coach of the Kincaid Falcons. We'll be back with more of the pregame show in just a moment on FoxSportsHouston.com.
If safety is your goal, Fabenco is your gate. Fabenco, the world's leading manufacturer of self-closing safety gates.
Welcome back into the pregame show. We're joined now by the head coach of the Episcopal Knights, Kyle Maneri, stops by for a visit. Coach, first of all, good to see you tonight. Congratulations on your season to this point. 27-3 and 6-0 in a conference. You're off to a great start.
Yeah, we've been fortunate. We even had some injuries, a lot of injuries, and each guy keeps stepping up. The next guy steps up. We've been fortunate. We played some solid teams and just been getting better each game.
Well, we were talking to Coach Zimmerman about his team, and he mentions the same sort of thing. And I guess as a coach, getting better as the season progresses is really what you're looking for.
Yeah, I think when you start the beginning of the year, you put a lot of emphasis on defense, even though it may not be there. Each game you play, you get a little better at it, a little better at rebound, a little better at executing offensively. And you don't want to peak early, you want to peak late.
Well, this is your first season as the head coach here at Episcopal. But for those who are watching and don't know, tell the folks a little bit about your background. You've been around the game for quite a while.
Yeah, I started out just young and hungry at 22 years old. Started out as a third assistant. Coached Division I college for a long time. Went to the Dallas Mavericks NBA. Did all international scouting for them. Did player development with about 90 NBA players with Coach John Lucas here in Houston. Currently, I run all the Nike Skills Academies in Jordan International Tour. Coached in the Jordan International All-American game last year. So, yeah, I stay busy with basketball. Been around it my whole life. So.
Well, and what's the transition been like for you, or has there been much of a transition into a high school head coaching position?
You know, the transition, the probably the biggest piece was just understanding like how much of an effect you can really have on a young man. You know, at the college and NBA level, you can coach them up and make them a lot better at players, but the effect that you have off the court is not as great as it is here, you know. So just understanding the dynamics of the kids, about how you deal with them daily, how important other things are to them, it's definitely a different dynamic, but it's been a lot of fun. And we got a lot of great kids. So.
And that reminds us that you are dealing with 15, 16, 17-year-old kids.
Yes, you see that quite often when you have a lot of game slippage. You know, you can call something in a huddle and come out, and the kids will still forget it. And it's part of it, though. It's part of their maturation process. They mature a little bit each game, and hopefully by the end of the year, getting right like now in SBC tournament, they're ready to go.
Now, having said that, it looks like, at least on paper, that you haven't had a lot of slippage out on the floor during your season, 27 wins and 30 starts.
Yeah. I wish we could have been 30 wins, but no, we've been pretty good, and the kids have been real open to learning and working hard in practice. It's a great group of kids. I mean, they dial in and they get after it every day. There's not a lot of relaxing, and I'm kind of an intense individual, so the kids, you know, they bring it every day, or we have a lot of conditioning. So.
And this is going to be an electric atmosphere tonight here. How important is this game, or what is the importance of this game?
You know, it's like I tell our kids, the next game on your schedule is the most important game. So we treat this just like any other game. The atmosphere will be great. We had probably 2,200 fans at the Episcopal St. John's game. It was unbelievable. Couldn't move in the gym, and I expect the same to be about here. And you know, but that's why we play the game. I told the kids, this is what's fun about it. You know, so it's just another game to us. We're trying to win. It's for a number one seed in the SBC tournament. But our approach stays the same. Everything all day, all week, and all day, it's been the same as every other game.
Best of luck to you.
Yes, thank you very much.
Kyle Maneri, the head coach of the Episcopal Knights, will come back with the starting lineups and all the action on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Since 1954, First Community Credit Union has been dedicated to providing the members of its community sound financial services in a personal, professional manner. From our roots as a school employees credit union, we now have grown to serving over 80,000 members with 13 lobby locations and over 37,000 ATM locations throughout the Houston area. Our advantage over other types of financial institutions is in that we are not for profit. This allows us to offer higher dividends on savings and lower interest rates on loans. We have always operated under the people helping people philosophy. And we look forward to serving you and your family in fulfilling all of your financial needs. For more information, please visit our website at www.fccu.org or give us a call at 281-856-5300.
I wanted something my whole family could enjoy. Danny loves basketball, Billy wants the batting cages, my husband's into football, and I'm training for a marathon. Then we found the Sports House, and now I'm one happy mom. With single and family options available, we found the membership just right for us. The Sports House offers a range of activities with group and private lessons overseen by pro and collegiate athletes. The Sports House even has a party room and offers an additional 25% off on Sundays. Check them out at thesportshouse.net. Dream big, play hard, train smart.
Try this. Is that chocolate? Is that whipped cream? Is that caramel and espresso you're mixing? I must be dreaming.
For the first time at McDonald's, your two favorite flavors together. New McCafe Caramel Mocha.
Well, what do you guys think?
Perfect.
The simple joy of sweet harmony.
When it just can't wait, come to Texas Emergency Care Center, where a licensed, freestanding emergency room open 24 hours a day, every day. Whether it's a broken bone or chest pain, the doctors and staff at Texas Emergency Care Center specialize in emergency medicine. We're ready and waiting, so you don't have to. At Texas Emergency Care Center, you'll be seen in minutes. We're open 24/7 in Pearland and Cypress, opening this summer in Atascocita. Find us online at txercare.com.
Well, the atmosphere here on the campus of the Kincaid School in the Memorial area of Houston is electric tonight. Joe, you and I are sitting right next to each other. It's going to be hard for us to hear. Luckily, we've got headsets, so it's a little bit easier now than it was in that open.
A lot easier, I tell you. The crowd, they got after it right away.
Yeah, these are two teams that have a bit of a rivalry due to the close proximity of the two schools, Episcopal and Bel Air, just a little bit south of here. And because also of the competitive nature of these two teams, both coming in here tonight 6-0. We heard the coaches talking about things, and both of them seem to dwell on the fact that they've gotten better as the season has gone along. And you, as a former head coach, can appreciate how important that is.
Well, I tell you, we always want to be playing our best ball, you know, at the end of January, going into February, to try to carry that into the playoffs. You know, I was fortunate as a head coach to, you know, make the playoffs some 15 straight years in a row. And that's the attitude that we had every year. Yeah, we'd lose some games early, but we want to be winning them late. And that's what counts.
So as a head coach then, I would assume that when you don't look at the overall record of a team, you kind of look at what they've done lately.
That's exactly right. Exactly right. And like I said, you know, it's that time of year where it's getting close to playoff time, and this is when you want to be playing your best ball.
Well, if you're looking at what they've done lately, Episcopal comes into this one with an 11-game winning streak. They're averaging nearly 65 points a game, giving up 41.7 on defense. Kincaid comes in. They dropped a non-conference game to HCYA last week. But other than that, they have won 9 of their last 10. So both teams playing very well in recent days. Here's the starting lineups for tonight's game. First of all, for the visitors in the road blues from Episcopal, they will be led on the floor by the leading scorer in the city, Ken Williams. He is a junior guard. He'll be joined out there on the floor by Jamal Williams, a 6'3 sophomore. Kendall Ramwal, a 6'6 junior, is 1-4. John Hurd, 6'4 senior, at the other forward. And then in the middle, big 6'8 Brandon Williams will play the post. He goes up against big man in the middle tonight for the Kincaid Falcons, Maven Saunders, a 6'6 sophomore. Jeff Roberson, a 6'4 forward. And Larry Wilkins, a 5'11 guard, the three leading scorers. And Episcopal controls the opening tip. We're underway in this one, and glad you're along for the ride. Duncan Robinson and Jeff Roberson in the lineup as well. A steal and a turnover gives the ball to the Falcons, and they've got their first possession here, moving right to left in the first half. Out top, Saunders has it. Gets across court to Wilkins. Wilkins, one of the big three, goes down low to Saunders, swinging around the arc. They're trying to set up the half-court offense. It looks like a man-to-man to start things off for Episcopal. And there's a pass thrown away. It'll go back over to Episcopal. So a couple of turnovers on both possessions.
Yeah, good nerves setting in. I tell you, I'm impressed with just the way these kids look. They, you know, most of them look like prospects.
There is some good size on both ends of the floor here for both these teams. Popping out to grab it is John Hurd. He looks for help and finds it in Ken Williams. He wears the number one and is the leading scorer not only on this team but among high school players in the area. Here's a runner on the baseline, and the reversal put up by Jamal Williams. Williams, the sophomore, gets the first bucket of the ballgame, 2-0 Episcopal. Thomas Dillon holds it up high. Now we've got a whistle as Duncan Robinson had the ball. And there's going to be a foul called. Watch it again here.
Jamal Williams.
And that must have been away from the ball. It certainly wasn't on the ball.
I think he called it on 22.
So he picks up his first. And that's also the team's first foul of the game. And there is another turnover. So a couple of trips up the floor, and Kincaid has thrown the ball away, and Episcopal will bring it back up. Comes Williams straight to the hole. Can't get it to go. Follow will be put up the second time through, and that is Brandon Williams. Williams with his first bucket. It's 4-0 Episcopal. Great atmosphere here at Melcher Gym on the campus of Kincaid. The ball knocked out of bounds by Episcopal. Stays in possession of Kincaid. Kincaid was founded in 1906. They've been a part of the SPC. The Southwest Prep Conference was formed in 1952. Here's a runner, a teardrop from the right side. Won't go off the iron. And Dillon can't get it to fall and back the other way. Episcopal, and now Williams is going to hold it up and he'll walk it across. Dribbles down left side into the corner. Hurd for three. Won't go. Rattles out. And the rebound up ahead on the run. Here's Saunders and he gets it to go. He looks like a basketball player, Coach.
Yeah, that's most definitely a prospect. He's wearing number 23. That's why.
He is just a sophomore. Here's a runner from Williams. Got it to go, and he's fouled. Acrobatic move. Let's look at it again. How'd that lane open up so wide for him there?
I tell you, you know, it's amazing. Both teams are running the same offense, dribble drive. And I guess it's just going to come down to who executes.
Free throw goes. It's 7-2. Here's a runner and foul on the play as Robinson tried to put the layup up and in. And Brandon Williams is going to pick up the foul, his first personal.
His first team second. Duncan Robinson at the line for two.
So Duncan Robinson, a 6'6 senior, will head to the free throw line. Robinson is a track athlete as well here at Kincaid. He is actually going to go to Stanford University next year to run track, run cross country, I believe, out there for Stanford. Misses both free throws here. And there's a loose ball. Fight for it on the floor. It's stolen away by Kincaid. Wilkins has it out top. He goes to Dillon. Dillon on the dribble, backs it out. Into the corner, they find Roberson. He can't get it to go off the iron. And the rebound comes off to Williams. Brandon Williams will bring it up. No relationship among the Williams, as Coach confirmed that for us tonight. There's a missed shot. Rebound comes out to Roberson. On the run, he looks for help, and he had Saunders, but it was knocked away. And I think it went off the fingertip of Saunders. But we're going to have a foul call. So Episcopal kind of bailed out the Falcons there.
Who was that foul on?
I didn't see the number and I didn't see the foul on that replay. Here's a jumper from the free throw line. Put up by Dillon, won't go, and the rebound comes off to the Knights. Ken Williams brings it up. He's going to pop from outside and hit. Three. Williams now has six of the first 10 points for the Knights with 4:07 to go here in the first quarter of play. Robinson's going to put up the answer from three-point land. Too strong, and the rebound taken by Brandon Williams. Pull up from Williams. Won't go. Bounces high and over the back.
I guess Williams is feeling it right now. I don't know if Coach wanted to take that shot. Coach, I'm open.
He's got the shooter's touch. 3:48 to go here in the first. Kincaid basketball. Single bucket here in the first quarter. Here's Saunders, who has that bucket. Shot won't go, but the rebound controlled by Roberson. He tries to back it down, and we've got a jump ball call. Possession arrow is going to keep it with Kincaid. Substitutions now into the game for Episcopal. Jordan Rutherford checks in, as does Austin Robinson, a couple of juniors. Baseline belonging to Kincaid. Bounce pass into Dillon and swatted at by Jamal Williams. And taken away by Episcopal, and we got a foul call. The block is going to be called on Larry Wilkins. Seeing again here, it looked like the Episcopal player might have been trying to clear with the offhand there, but
yeah. I guess he didn't give him enough room to come down.
Now we got a turnover going back the other way, a foul call, and that equals it out right there. Yeah. 10-2 here, 3.5 minutes, a little less than 3.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Episcopal, one of the top-ranked teams in the area. Dillon dribbles down on the baseline, bounce pass. They find it. Robinson just open it inside the free throw line. Can't get the short-range jumper to go in the bounce. Goes out of bounds off of Kincaid. You get the sense that maybe the adrenaline's pumping just a little too hard right now for the Falcons. On the run, here's a runner with the left hand. And Jamal Williams gets his second bucket. And a timeout called by Scott Zimmerman. 2:59 to go in the first quarter. We'll take it with a 12-2 Episcopal with the lead here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
And reputable. Those are just a few of the words that could be used to describe Meador Staffing, one of Houston's largest staffing services. Meador has gained a superior reputation over the past four decades, serving Houston's employers, providing all types of direct hire, contract, contract to hire, temporary, and temp to hire job candidates. If you have a job to fill or looking for a job, call Meador Staffing 713-941-0616. Follow Meador on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. Meador Staffing, they know the people you need to know.
Saw the big throwdown by Maven Saunders. That, to this point, is the only Kincaid bucket here in the first 5 minutes and 1 second of the first quarter. So it's been a very good start for the road team tonight.
I tell you, in the road team right now that they have on the floor, they look like all of them just got to take some Similac with iron. They look so young. Look at those guys.
Hey, they're so young, they don't need Similac.
Oh, man, they look young.
There's a pass down low, knocked out of bounds, and it's going to go over to Episcopal. So another turnover for Kincaid. And you can tell that this is a big game in the Southwest Preparatory Conference, the SPC South Division. Both these teams are 6-0. Kincaid would really like to come away with a win. This, as you heard Coach Maneri tell us, is for the top seed in the playoffs that start next week. There's a tip controlled on the baseline and a jumper put up by Jordan Rutherford, his first bucket off the bench. 6'5 junior. Got a good lot of good size for Coach Kyle Maneri. There's a miss and a rebound again by Episcopal. On the move, Williams. On the dribble, he'll be fouled, and the foul's going to be on Dillon. They're just allowing Kincaid one look at the bucket each time up the floor.
Yeah, they're doing a good job on those defensive boards. Real good job.
Basketball belongs to Episcopal on the baseline. A little bit of confusion. Larry Wilkins thought he had checked out of the game, but he's still out on the floor, and so he heads back out there, and we're ready to go. Baseline, Ken Williams gets it inbounds. He goes to Lloyd Julian, who's checked in, and we got a whistle and a foul called on Duncan Robinson of Kincaid. He's tried to reach in with the right hand there, and swatted at the basketball, came up with flesh instead. Dribbling through traffic, Brandon Williams leaves it on the baseline for Robinson, and we've got a whistle. And Duncan Robinson is going to pick up the foul. The pass was intended for Austin Robinson of Episcopal, and he is fouled. They call Duncan Robinson of Kincaid for the personal. And now that is five team fouls here in the first quarter.
That three personals on Duncan?
I believe you're right, yes. He's going to have to check out, and checking in for him will be John Ormiston, a 6'5 senior.
Duncan probably will have to sit the rest of the half.
First free throw from Austin Robinson was no good, but he gets a second one to go, and it's 15-2 here, under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Full court pressure this time, and broken by Kincaid, but a nice recovery, knocked out of bounds by Lloyd Julian. It'll stay in possession of the Falcons. But Episcopal is tenacious. We heard Coach Maneri telling us before the game, he's kind of a high-energy guy, and his team plays like that.
Yeah, real high energy.
Here's a steal. Williams on the run, up and won't go, but he's fouled on the way. Just could not get it to go. Jamal Williams will head to the line.
Really one of the biggest difference both teams is Episcopal has just so much quickness. I mean, foot speed, quickness.
Jamal Williams too strong on the first free throw. One more to come. Gets the second one to go. So one out of two, and now it's 16-2. At the floor, Steven Osuji, who's checked in, had the basketball. Inside they go, and there's going to be a whistle on the rebound.
We'll be shooting free throws here in a little bit.
That is number five, I believe, the 15 foul.
17 foul.
Oh, that was on Kincaid. You're right. I thought for a moment there they had called a foul on Episcopal. Scott Zimmerman seems a little confused. But that is the 17th foul, so we still got 1:26 to go in the first quarter, and they're going to be shooting the bonus from here on in.
Yep.
First free throw is good. That is Rutherford at the line again. Our check at Austin Robinson. Two of three now from the stripe. Three of four, gets both these to go. So he's got 3 points in the game, all from the free throw line, and it's 18-2. To start this one, there's a runner put up by Roberson. He can't get it to fall. Back the other way in a hurry. Here comes Episcopal. Almost a walk, no call, and a steal by Kincaid. Back up the floor. Osuji behind the back dribble. Now he pulls up, looks for help. Finds it in the form of Campbell Cravens. Dribbles down left side, back out top to Osuji. Picked up out top by Lloyd Julian. Dribble into the paint, high off the glass, counted, and going to the line is going to be Jeff Roberson. Good strong move here, Coach.
Yeah, it was a good finish. Good concentration.
And Jamal Williams off his feet with the body, and that will be the fifth team foul on Episcopal. Now it's 18-4. And Roberson trying to add to that. Misses the free throw, though, and there's a fight for it on the floor. And it's tied up, and the possession arrow belongs to Episcopal. Derek Huneke is checking in for the Knights, number 33 in the blue uniform. Defense! Out top with the basketball, Lloyd Julian into the corner. He goes, and there's a three, won't go off the rim, and we've got a foul on the rebound. Hurd put up that shot, and the rebound was fought for, and loose ball. Derek Heneke picked up the foul going over the back there, you see, of Osuji. So on the offensive foul, no shots, and so it'll be inbounded by the Falcons, and they'll bring it up with under 30 seconds to go. Two baskets here in the first quarter for Kincaid, looking to finish it strong, though, but there's a steal by Episcopal. 15 seconds, pulling up and popping from the wing. It won't go. Shot was put up by Rutherford, and the rebound controlled by Kincaid. Cravens has it. Leaves it for Osuji. Down to 1 second. The shot won't go at the buzzer, and that's the end of the first quarter. 18-4, Episcopal on the road has jumped out to a big lead through 8 minutes of play. Second quarter coming up straight ahead right here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Life is a road you travel with many destinations, like college for the kids, a new house, and retirement. I am Earl Thompson, your neighborhood State Farm agent, and I can do more than ever to guide you with a State Farm insurance and financial review. You'll get a clear picture of where you stand now and a way to help you plan for where you want to be. Visit me on the web, earlthompson.biz, to schedule your free insurance and financial review. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Gym on the campus of Kincaid, and a slow start for the home team tonight. Coach Joe Price, I'm sure in your coaching tenure, you've had teams get off to slow starts. What do you try to do as a head coach when that happens?
Well, you try to settle them down a little bit. You know, I probably say some things to them like, hey, guys, I'm okay, you're okay. You know, something like that, and just tell them just keep fighting, because basketball really is a game of sports. You know, I think each team's going to have theirs. I know Episcopal has had one in his first quarter, but I look for Kincaid to play a lot better here when it's all said and done.
But it starts with a steal here on the first possession, and Kenny Williams puts up the layup with the nice move to the basket. And he's got eight, leads all scorers in this game, and it's 20-4 here for the Episcopal Knights. There's another tip and a steal. They fill up the passing lanes very well. Williams strong to the hole. And that's 10, and a quick timeout called by Scott Zimmerman as he's got to talk it over with his team. So we'll take a break here on FoxSportsHouston.com. Episcopal out quickly tonight, 22-4 on FoxSportsHouston.com.
HBU has returned to NCAA Division I athletics. Come and enjoy the most intimate setting of all of Division I. HBU Athletics is also the most affordable entertainment option in Houston. The HBU Huskies, a member of the Great West Conference, experience success on the field with conference championships in women's soccer, women's golf, and softball. With great recruiting classes in men's and women's basketball and baseball, HBU Athletics is on the move and on the way up. For more information on HBU opportunities in the classroom and on the field, visit us on the web, hbuhuskies.com.
Two quick layups to start the second quarter here by Ken Williams. He's got 10 points now, and Episcopal out to an 18-point lead. Joe, we talked about it before the break, but it seems like every time down the floor on offense for Kincaid, Episcopal on defense has a hand in a passing lane, and they get a hand on the ball and force a turnover or at least disrupt the offense.
Yeah, that can happen sometimes if you're standing around on offense too much. You know, now right now, Episcopal is in a 2-3 zone, but versus the man-to-man, you're going to have to get some type of movement. Movement by bodies
And there's a nice move to the hole by Jeff Roberson. He went strong, and he's got four now. Doubles his output from the first quarter. And it's 22-6. Just under 7 minutes to go here in the first half. Ken Williams with a teardrop from the left angle, and he gets it to go down. Six in the quarter now for the leading scorer in the area. Roberson on the baseline. Loses his dribble, kicks it across court. Dillon puts up the jumper. It's short, and the rebound off to Williams on the run. Up ahead, Rutherford lays it up and in. Good spacing on the passing lanes on the break that time.
It was outstanding.
Here's Saunders on the baseline, tries to go across court, off the glass, and up ahead. Rutherford puts it up, it goes, and he's fouled. Coach, you ever had a night where everything goes right?
I tell you, it's like Murphy's Law set in on Kincaid. Whatever can go wrong, will go wrong.
28-6, and Rutherford goes to the line now. Williams put up six quick points, and now Rutherford has put up a couple of baskets here to start the second. And he gets the free throw to go as well. So now he's got five in the ball game.
Kincaid's gonna have to do something to stop the bleeding. Now they're gonna get ran out of their own gym. Yeah, the Episcopal right around hollering, it's our house.
Yeah. They've got a good representation here tonight from their student body. And there's a short shot from three-point land, and the rebound bounces all the way out to one of the Knights. Here's Haneke, and he hits from the angle, and that's a three. Big Derek Haneke headed for Stanford to run track. And it's 32-6. To 18 points in the first quarter for Episcopal. They've already got 14 here, and we're just 3 minutes in. There's a nice move by Maven Saunders. And I would imagine the formula for Kincaid is to get him going a little bit more. 32-8. Now we've got a whistle, and there is a foul going to be called.
Last basket for Episcopal by number three. John Hurd.
You're right. Three and not 33.
Yeah.
So Hurd's got five. Give the credit where it belongs. Here's a runner, Dillon into the corner. Larry Wilkins can't get it to go, and the rebound is fought for. We've got a whistle. And we talk about John Hurd, and he picks up the foul here. Watch this again. Well, the ball hits the floor like that. It's going to be a scramble for the 30-second timeout here on the floor. We'll keep it right here with 4:49 to go in the first half.
You know, you were talking earlier about Coach from Episcopal having so much intensity about himself. And you could tell his demeanor. But one of the things I've noticed, he's playing quite a few guys, and they all are playing hard, and that's what you want. Yeah, that's all you can ask of a kid, just go out there and go hard.
Well, yeah. And I would imagine that's got to play in his favor, too, that he gets a lot of his bench involved in a big game. You know, a lot of times coaches have an opportunity to go deep on their bench in the games that don't mean a lot, but then they shorten that rotation in the big games. He's been able in this big game to keep all his guys that are on the bench involved in the action.
Oh, he's already played at least 10 guys in the first half.
Roberson to the line for Kincaid here. Jeff Roberson is a junior. I check it, he's just a sophomore. You think about this, Maven Saunders and Jeff Roberson, the two big guns for Kincaid as that one rolls out, are just sophomores for Scott Zimmerman.
That's a good little nucleus to build on.
4:35 and counting. Brandon Williams dribbles down, has it tipped and stripped. And up ahead, Roberson to Saunders. Saunders is going to pull up, pop from the left wing. Too strong. Just not finding the range outside yet. Back the other way. Here comes number one, Kenny Williams. And he's going to draw
Kenny
a foul.
Williams, one of the leading scorers in the area.
The leading scorer. And
he's a sophomore?
He is actually a junior.
Okay.
We had him listed as a sophomore, but Coach Maneri corrected us. He is a junior.
I was about to ask you, where is he from?
And why haven't we heard from him before?
Yeah.
He is a junior, and Kyle Maneri, as we said, is a first-year head coach, has got to be thanking his lucky stars to have him on his squad. Hits both free throws. Now he's got 8 in the second quarter, 14 in the first half. Well, he forces the action. He's not just a jump shooter. He's a penetrator,
yeah.
And that'll create a lot of scoring opportunities. Roberson tried a reversal underneath, won't go. Gets his own rebound, follows it up. Too strong off the iron. And Ken Williams rebounds that one. He's all over the floor, and it's knocked out of bounds off the foot of Jeff Roberson. And that'll give it back to Episcopal. 34-8. They're out to a 26-point lead here in the first half. There's a pass. Too strong to Brandon Williams. That one from Lloyd Julian bounces away and stolen. Off the floor, saved in the corner. At cross court, Dillon's going to slow things down, set it up. He tried to find Saunders, knocked out of bounds. And there again is Episcopal getting in the passing lane and disrupting the offense.
Yep. Stand around. That's what happened.
Austin Robinson that time knocks it out of bounds. It'll stay in possession of Kincaid. Dillon puts it up on the run. He caught a body from...
I'm real surprised that Coach Zimmerman brought Duncan back in with 3 fouls.
Williams, Kenny Williams picked up the personal that time. And the free throw from Dillon rolls off. Now, I'm sure Coach Zimmerman can't be really happy about that. His team is getting to the line now, but they're not converting the opportunities.
If they made one free throw.
One more to come here for Thomas Dillon, 5'10 sophomore, who runs the point. So 3 sophomores in the starting lineup for this team, and he gets the second one to go down through. 34-9 here, 3.5 to go in the first half. Hurd finds Rutherford on the baseline, right side, won't go, and a rebound off to Duncan Robinson. Outlet to Dillon. He brings it up, backs it out as Rutherford's there to get him. Screen from Robinson, puts up the jumper, and he gets it to go. First field goal for Dillon, and there's a steal by Roberson. Into the corner, back to Roberson on the give and go, and he puts it up. Had it knocked out of bounds. He was looking for a foul, and so were some of the fans in the stands.
Yeah. I needed Lick to go strong to the hole.
2:56 to go. Still a lot of time in this one. Just in the second quarter. Dillon's jumper from 3 is short, though, and the rebound off to Episcopal. Julian lost control of the dribble. And Coach Maneri is arguing that it was tipped by Larry Wilkins of Kincaid, but going to be a turnover and goes back over to the Falcons. So what's the goal right now, Joe? You, if you're Scott Zimmerman, you want to try and just eat into this lead a little bit by halftime, I guess.
Yeah, down 23. We got to get it below 20 going into the half and hopefully around 15 somewhere along in there.
Dillon. Here's an alley-oop underneath for Roberson. The feed from Larry Wilkins, and Roberson gets the layup to go. six, or check at seven in the first half. Jump shot from her, won't go. Rebound controlled on the baseline by Williams, and he can't get it to go. Back the other way, here comes Dillon, and it's blocked by Rutherford. Jamal Williams in a hurry, and Dillon, a little bit of a frustration foul right there.
Yeah. Double bonus free throw.
Yep, the 10th team foul. Dillon's going to have to go to the bench.
I tell you, Coach Zimmerman is getting pretty feisty there with the officials. He don't want to get too feisty with Mel Wentworth. He'll take him up real quick, I guarantee you. With no hesitation.
First free throw from Jamal Williams is good. He's got six now, two of three at the line. And exactly 2 minutes to go till halftime. Stick with us at the half. We'll recap the first half scoring and talk over some of the highlights of the first half and set you up for second half action right here on FoxSportsHouston.com. Both free throws good. Here's a runner put up with the right hand, and that's Osuchi. And he gets it to go down through his first bucket of the ball game. And it's 36-15, down to 21. Here's Heineke tried to put it up, blocked. Here's Saunders with the slam. Six points for Saunders now, and it's under 20, Coach.
Yep.
36-19, or 17. Here's Heineke again, long distance dial up, won't go. A check it, that was heard, and Heineke with the board. And it's going to go back over to Kincaid.
That slam dunk, it'll turn things around.
Energize the home crowd here a little
right.
bit. Now a chance to cut into it a little bit further. Osuchi passes tip. Saunders for three, misses everything. And Rutherford back the other way. In a hurry, goes to Hurd, who saves it in the corner. Back out top to Rutherford. Dribbles down right side now. Lane opens up on the baseline. He was surprised, and I think he was so shocked, he was so wide open that he couldn't make the basket.
Yep.
Osuchi out top. Under 30 seconds we go now here in the first half. Roberson left angle. Osuchi playing out around the perimeter. Roberson now dribbles down through traffic, has a look, and he can't get it to go. Picks up his own board, follows, it goes, count it, and he'll go to the line. Jordan Rutherford's going to pick up the personal, and that is number 10 on the night. But a nice follow that time. Good job of sticking with it by Jeff Roberson. And the free throw is good as well. Almost a steal. Down under 10 seconds. And Jamal Williams is going to be fouled, and that's going to be free throws. And 4 seconds to go, Coach. You send him to the line.
I think it's offensive foul. I don't know if they're a cheap coach.
Oh, you're right. They did call it. I thought I saw him call a block there. Almost a steal, and now it is stolen, and time runs out. And that is the end of the first half here. So a back and forth first 16 minutes of play. A great start for the visitors from Episcopal, but a nice little rebound toward the end of the second quarter for Kincaid. We'll come back and recap the first half and give you some of the numbers as well and set you up for the second half when we return here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
You know why I love Walmart?
You got this at Walmart? No way.
Way.
Whew, I almost bought one of these at another store. No way. Way.
They have the same brand name TVs as the pricey electronics stores.
No way. Way.
That's all you paid? No way. Way. So we got a great TV and we had money left over to save.
Get the best brands like Sony, Sharp, Samsung, and Vizio at the Walmart price. Save money. Live better. Walmart.
Something my whole family could enjoy. Danny loves basketball, Willie wants the batting cages, my husband's into football, and I'm training for a marathon. Then we found the Sports House, and now I'm one happy mom. With single and family options available, we found the membership just right for us. The Sports House offers a range of activities with group and private lessons overseen by pro and collegiate athletes. The Sports House even has a party room and offers an additional 25% off on Sundays. Check them out at thesportshouse.net. Dream big, play hard, train smart.
The Episcopal Knights jumped out to an 18-4 lead in the first quarter of action here on the FoxSportsHouston.com Game of the Week here from Melcher Gym at Kincaid over the home team tonight, the Kincaid Falcons. But Kincaid got things going a little bit in the second quarter. They fell even further behind, but wound up with a little run toward the end of the second quarter and finish up trailing by 16, 36 to 20 at the half. Episcopal out to a quick start. They had 14 points in the first 2.5 minutes, Joe, and then managed only 4 in the last 5.5. So the defensive intensity picked up a little bit for Kincaid.
Yeah, it picked up a lot, you know, despite the fact they were down 14 going into the second quarter. They pretty much kind of matched them point for point there at that second quarter, although they got out of score by 2. But, you know, there was a little bit of urgency there at the last 2 or 3 minutes of the second quarter. And it's a sign that, you know, they got potential to get back in this game. I mean, it could be a tale of two halves, you know, best of times, the worst of times. And right now, the Kincaid Falcons have had the worst of times probably at first 14 minutes of the first half.
Well, we talked about some of the floor leaders for both these teams, and the coaches talked about them as well. Ken Williams for Episcopal has done the job for his head coach tonight, the junior guard. He kind of runs the offense, but he is one of those scoring point guards. And he's in at halftime with 14 points in the first half, leading all scorers in this game. He's really looked good here in the first half.
Outstanding. You know, he's definitely a college prospect, you know, being a junior. Probably got some more growing to do. And, you know, I'm just looking at his triceps, his biceps, and they haven't developed yet. So he still got a ways to go. But he's a pretty good little player.
Yeah, and then on the other side of the ball, I think the first quarter was maybe a case of young players for Kincaid, sophomores and juniors who make up the big core of this starting lineup for them. Two sophomores in Roberson and Saunders who kind of let the intensity and the excitement of the situation maybe get to them a little bit. But when they settled down in the second quarter, they looked very good as well.
Exactly right. You know, both Roberson and Saunders, both were young guys, and they're probably the leaders on this team in spite of that. But, you know, they came out a little nervous. But, you know, in the end there, that last 2 minutes, they played a little bit better.
Now, if you're Coach Scott Zimmerman, you're in at halftime talking to your team. You mentioned that after the slow first quarter that you would talk to your team as a head coach and tell them, hey, we're okay. Right. And I would imagine that's still got to be the theme for him at halftime.
Well, you know, I was watching an NBA game last week. I think it was the Boston Celtics. And I forgot who they were playing, but they were down 20-something. And coach just kept telling them, hey, we're okay. And some kind of way they found a way to come back and win. You know, I mean, they just didn't stop playing. I would say to the guys, don't stop playing. Keep going hard. Things might turn in our favor. You know, like I said, it's two halves.
And the second half is just moments away from getting underway. So when we come back, we'll have the second half action for you right here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Next in line.
If you're in-
interested in playing college sports, follow the paths of hundreds of successful athletes at San Jacinto College. Our athletic programs offer men's basketball, baseball, and soccer, women's basketball, volleyball, and softball. All of our teams have an excellent reputation as most go on to compete in national championships, and some of our student athletes have gone professional. In fact, we have former players in Major League Baseball, NBA, and Major League Soccer. Visit sanjacsports.com for more information. San Jacinto College, your goals, your college.
Episcopal outscored Kincaid 18-4 in the first quarter, outscored them 18-16 in the second quarter, but noticeably different Kincaid team in the last 5 minutes of that second quarter. So we'll see if or how that carries over here into the second half as we are set to go. It'll be Episcopal basketball to get things underway here in the third quarter. They're moving right to left as you look on tonight on FoxSportsHouston.com. Hurd into the corner. There's Ken Williams. And he stays hot. Halftime break didn't cool him down, and he's got 17 with that three. Back up to a 19-point lead for the Knights. Dillon to Wilkins. Back to Dillon. He tries to dribble down, kicks it on the baseline. Saunders for three. Nice touch there, and it's first time he's found the range from beyond the arc. And now he's got nine and ties Roberson for the scoring lead on the Falcons.
Yeah, I think his first 4 minutes, this third quarter, going to be really important for Kincaid.
39-23. Here's a turnaround. Brandon Williams in the paint. Puts it up with the right hand, and he got it to go with a nice little baby hook. Answer comes in the form of a three from Wilkins. Too strong, though, and the rebound off to Episcopal. Williams on the run, and nobody picks him up, and he takes it right to the hole. There's a baseline jumper put up from Tempe. Won't go. Williams again on the run, and traffic goes, and he's going to go to the line.
We put on a one-man clinic.
Well, he got in his way that time, Coach, and he just went through a pair of Falcons. But that last time, Coach, how do you, when he's got the basketball, how do you look away and go pick up somebody else?
Yeah, it's hard.
45-23, and he's got a chance to make it 46-23. And with the free throw, he doubles up the scoreboard for Episcopal over Kincaid, 46-23, 6.5 and counting here in the third quarter. Spin move by Roberson. Won't go, and the rebound pulled off by Williams. Down low to Rutherford. He finds or looks on the baseline. He was trying to go to Kendall Ramwall, the sophomore, or check out the junior. And it just went through his hands and goes back over to the Falcons. Kincaid looking for an opportunity to cut into the lead a little bit here. Asuji. Roberson into Saunders in the paint. He's going to be called for the offensive foul. Watch it again. He's just a little bit out of control with the body that time.
Yeah. Guy had great position.
Maybe if he had not lowered that shoulder. The runner on the baseline. It was Brandon Williams trying to put it up, but there's a foul before the shot on the pass. The baseline out. Third foul on the Falcons. Still no team fouls here in the second half on Episcopal. Here's an alley-oop, and Brandon Williams lays it up and in.
That was a set play, I guarantee.
Twelve points already here in the quarter, and another quick start to a period by Episcopal. There's a whistle and a foul, and this one is going to be called on Kendall Ramlal. As Saunders trying to go to the hole, and the bucket is just not friendly here tonight for the Falcons. Saunders too strong on the first free throw. Good news for fans of both of these squads is that this is not a win or go home game. Both these teams will be in the playoffs, and both of them are expected to make pretty deep runs in the playoffs. The second free throw from Saunders is good. And the tournament starts next week. There's a turnover by Episcopal, going to give it right back to the Falcons, so they can try to cut this lead down a little bit with this possession. Roberson to Wilkins on the baseline, and he dribbled it on the baseline. It's a turnover, gives it back to Episcopal. Pressure on the full court, but broken by Williams. Jamal Williams with the left hand lays it up and in. And that's 50 now for Episcopal. With 5.5 to go here in the third quarter. Williams with his first bucket of the second half. Wilkins finds Roberson, puts it up, off the iron, won't go. Nothing falling for Kincaid tonight. Just tough luck from the field tonight. Here's Ken Williams to the hole, and that's one of those where everything he's been throwing up seems to go in. You're surprised when it doesn't.
Yeah.
Even a shot like that. But he's fouled and will go to the free throw line. He's already got 8 in the quarter here, 22 points in the ball game for Kenny Williams. And free throws to come here with 5:07 to go, and the first one is good. I've got him 5 of 5 from the line, Coach. Does that match what you show?
That's exactly right.
Misses that. I knew I could jinx him, but the rebound is put up and in. And so even when things go wrong, they go right for Episcopal tonight, 53-24. There's a steal in the corner. Brandon Williams loses the ball, though, and it's going to go out of bounds. Fight with Duncan Robinson on the floor for possession, and Kincaid will come up with it. 4:48 to go here in the third quarter. Robinson looks for help, gets it into Saunders, dribbles through the paint, puts it up with the right hand, and that one stays down. Looked like it wanted to come back out, but it stays and goes. 6 points in the quarter now for Saunders. Here's a runner on the answer from Jamal Williams, and he gets it to go down through. Roberson end-to-end action. That one won't go. Follows his own shot, and he's going to be fouled. Brandon Williams will pick up the personal.
Episcopal foul ball on number 11, Brandon Williams. His second personal, second team foul.
Now the action is going fast and furious on both ends, and you saw Williams just got the arms up and reached in just a little bit to send Roberson to the line. That free throw gets him into double digits, and he's now got 10 points. One more free throw to come. And Jeff Roberson, the sophomore, gets both of them to go. On the runner, Williams is going to be fouled. And it's going to be called on Cravens, who's checked back in. And saw him go up there, got him with the body. 4:12 to go. Williams back to the line now to try and add to this lead. And hits the first free throw. One more to come. Told you that coming into this game, Kincaid actually averaging two more points per game, 66.8 per ball game to 64.8 for Episcopal. But defensively, the difference is shown tonight. Episcopal holds their opponents to 41 a game, and that's kind of the range that it looks like the Falcons are headed for right now. There's a steal and back the other way. Here comes Jamal Williams, gets it to go, and he's fouled.
Nice move by Jamal.
Well, that's one of those where there's not a whole lot you can do if you're that last man underneath the basket. Jamal Williams picks up the bucket and goes to the line.
6'3" sophomore. Yeah, he got a couple more growth spurts.
Man, both these coaches, though, have to be sort of licking their chops to think that the nucleus of both these teams are going to be back next year as strong as they are, and they're fighting for first place and the top seed in the playoffs here in this game tonight. That's going to be a whale of a rivalry over the next couple of years, you got to think.
I tell you, well, September I'll be hosting a preseason shootout. I'm going to try to invite these guys, see if I can get them over.
59-28, the free throw was not good. But a 31-point lead right now for the Knights. Cravens out high. Looks for help. Steal. Here's Robinson, and he's going to lay it up and in. Austin Robinson, and some of the Episcopal fans were hoping he'd finish it off with a tomahawk, but he lays it up and in, and it's 61-28. Now, this is the best quarter by far for Episcopal. 25 points in the third period. Shot is missed. Rebound by Robinson, and on the run again. Rutherford to Williams in the corner to Hurd for three. Rattles out. Roberson with the board for Kincaid. On the run, tries to find Saunders. Led him a little too far, and now he got a steal and a foul by Cravens.
I really think Kincaid's coaches have given up. You know, what can you do?
Well, it just seems to be one of those nights where everything and timing is such an overlooked and the rhythm of a game is so overlooked, I think, sometimes. But when you're just a little bit off on that rhythm, it just, you have a night that winds up looking like this.
Yeah. Right.
Back to the line is Jamal Williams. Shoot a pair now. Going to get some substitutions. Lloyd Julian is checked back in. The free throw is no good. And again, with still 2:50 to go in the third, Episcopal is in the bonus, and there's a layup put up and in by Saunders. And he's got 8 in the quarter now for Kincaid. Here's a shot, blocked and stolen away, but taken right back by Episcopal. Williams. No-look pass on the baseline to Julian. He can't get it to go. And the rebound off to Saunders. He's on the run. Takes it up. Strong. Won't go, but he's going to draw a foul. Austin Robinson will pick up the personal. And it'll send Maven Saunders to the free throw line. .215 to go here in the third quarter of play. 61-30 is our score. We're ready to see some more substitutions now as Stuart Cartwright is checking in for the first time tonight for Episcopal. And back out on the floor is Kendall Ramlal. Robinson will sit down. Heineke will sit down. 61-31 and 61-32 as Saunders sinks both free throws. He's got 10 in the quarter now, 16 in the ball game. Said it early, he looks like a player, Coach.
Yeah, most definitely.
Here's a give and go and blocked by Roberson, another good-looking player for Kincaid. Blocked that shot, under 2 minutes to go, and they come back the other way. On the run, teardrop put up by Osuji, won't go, but the rebound is taken down by Bryson King, who's checked in, and he's going to draw a foul and will go to the line. King is a 6'4 junior, seeing his first action of the ball game and found himself right there in the middle of the action. And he's going to get a couple of free throws, but we got a timeout on the floor with 1:47 to go. 61-32 Episcopal when we come back on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Looks like there's an opening for shipping coordinator, and I've got to pick someone.
Okay, you just ordered a crispy McChicken and a fresh brewed sweet tea for only a buck each off McDonald's dollar menu. So you're smart.
Nah, I got nothing.
Well, you saw one of the bright spots here on the evening for the Kincaid Falcons, that three-point baseline jumper from Saunders, and those have been few and far between as the Falcons, the home team here tonight, find themselves down by 29, and at the line, Bryson King. This is the first free throw, one more to come. Second free throw rattles out as well, so no luck at the line for young Mr. King that time. And here's almost a steal, but saved by Julian, and he had the shot blocked out of bounds. It'll stay in possession of Episcopal. Knights with 1:37 here in the third quarter will inbound it from the baseline. Give and go right back to Brandon Williams in the paint. Puts up the short-range jumper, rattles out, and the rebound taken by Jeff Roberson for Kincaid. Osuji brings it up the floor, pulls it up outside on the right side. King back to Osuji. Looks for help, pick from Roberson. Dillon and Cravens now, who's checked back in on the dribble, takes it down right side. Roberson dribbles down into the paint, loses his footing, and has it knocked away, but it's saved by Cravens. Into the corner. Dillon on the run, puts it up with the dipsy do, won't go, and the rebound controlled by Williams. Out in the pass, up ahead to Rutherford. He's going to lay it off the glass for two. Rutherford released early that time, and he was just back there to catch the freebies, and here's the rebound, comes off to Episcopal, and now Williams is going to back it out. Pulls it up out high, leaves it right side for Julian. Under 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter of play, and this one more so than any of the other two has been all Episcopal. Williams on the dribble, loses his footing, saves it to Julian, tries to find Rutherford on the baseline, got it to go, no, did not get it to go, but he'll go to the line. 3 seconds left on the third quarter clock, watch this again. Threaded the needle with that assist that time. Rutherford at the line. This is the first one. One more to come.
It's been a big quarter for Episcopal.
Sure has. They scored 36 in the first half, and they're already out 27 points here in the third quarter. 28 now as he hits the second free throw. One of two at the line. Down to the final second, and the long distance shot won't go, and that's the end of the third quarter. But a productive one for the visitors. Episcopal Knights looking to take the SPC South Division Championship back home tonight.
Has one of the largest temporary help divisions in the Houston area. Each week, the company pays over 2,000 temporaries, working on many and varied assignments. Metter Staffing can help your company when you have needs for your employees. Call us at 713-941-0616 to speak with one of our experienced staffing consultants who can assist you with your staffing challenges. That number is 713-941-0616. They now offer video resumes as a job-seeking tool. Ask about it today. Metter Staffing. They know the people you need to know.
Life is a road you travel with many destinations, like college for the kids, a new house, and retirement. I am Earl Thompson, your neighborhood State Farm agent, and I can do more than ever to guide you with a State Farm insurance and financial review. You'll get a clear picture of where you stand now and a way to help you plan for where you want to be. Visit me on the web, earlthompson.biz, to schedule your free insurance and financial review. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Episcopal outscored Kincaid 28-12 in the third quarter of play. It'll be Kincaid's basketball to start the fourth quarter, but Joe, now it's probably just a matter of playing for a little bit of pride here in these final 8 minutes.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Dillon got the runner to go. First bucket, and there's almost a steal, but saved by Williams. He'll take it right through the heart of the paint and scoops it up and in for two. Williams now with 25 points in the ball game. There's a baseline runner put up by Dillon. So he's got the first four here in this final quarter, and Brandon Williams has the answer. And it's 68-36. Long distance jumper. Osuji can't get it to go off the iron. The rebound controlled by Brandon Williams. He's going to take it coast to coast and can't get it to go with the right hand. Took it to the left side and tried to put it up with the right hand and just had no angle on it. And the rebound is going to be actually a foul called on Stuart Cartwright, who picks up the personal. So it'll give it back over to the Falcons with 6:50 to go here in the final quarter of play.
And do these two teams just play one time?
One time in conference. They could meet up again in the playoff bracket. Here's a runner. And you've got to think that if that were to happen, Kincaid's going to circle that game.
Oh, most definitely.
Foul is called on Lloyd Julian. He picks up the personal. That's 16 fouls for Episcopal in the second half. Next one puts Kincaid in the bonus. And the Knights are already in the bonus. 18 fouls on the Falcons. Baseline out. Osuji in to Dillon. Dillon out top to Wilkins. Wilkins has been held silent most of the night. Dillon, runner with the right hand, won't go. Followed by Osuji, won't go. Gets his own rebound, though. Look for Rutherford in traffic and stolen, but taken back by Osuji. And he finally gets it to go down through. Get some credit for the effort there. Here's Ken Williams. Lays it off for Brandon Williams, and he can't slam it down through. Rebound bounces off and up ahead, and the pass intended for Roberson goes out of bounds. And so it'll go right back over to the Knights. Under 6 minutes to go now in this one. Just been one of those nights for Kincaid.
Yep, like I said, Murphy's Law.
Full court pressure this time, but Broken easily by Episcopal. Rutherford on the run with the right hand. Won't go, and a foul on the rebound. It's going to be called on Brandon Williams. No, check it. It's going to be called on Austin Robinson. See it here. He came up over the back of Dylan there. That is his seventh team foul, so that puts Kincaid in the bonus, and Thomas Dillon will shoot free throws. Now we're going to see William Belt check in for his first action. He's a senior. He's going to get some time here in the final 6 minutes of action. Hunneke's going to check back in for Episcopal, as will Jamal Williams. This is the final regular season game in the Southwest Preparatory Conference for both these teams. Next weekend, the playoffs begin. First free throw from Dillon is good. Second one too strong, one out of two at the line. And the rebound pulled off by Julian Lloyd. Or Lloyd Julian, excuse me. Ken Williams fights through a double team. Loses it, but gets it back and lays it off for Hunneke. Derek Hunneke gets the bucket. His first of the ball game. Here's Wilkins trying to answer. Short. And the outlet pass up ahead to Williams on the run. He's going to take it to the hole, high off the glass, and in for two. 72-39. Roberson back the other way on the run. Won't go. And Coach, usually you expect a little friendlier roll on the home floor than the Falcons are getting tonight.
Yeah, they're playing like they're the road team.
Roberson to the line, though, and he hits the first free throw. Got a good-looking touch. Belt, who has checked in, is the senior. Campbell Cravens, who was playing earlier for Kincaid, is a senior. John Ormiston, who saw a few minutes in the first half, is a senior. And Duncan Robinson, number 40 out on the floor for Kincaid, a senior as well. But the rest of these guys for the Falcons are underclassmen and will be back. And got to think a year of seasoning under their belt and some of the summer programs like you were talking about
right.
are going to help them.
Well, most of them will probably all play together in the same AAU program.
There's a jumper from Dillon. It's going to be off the mark. Hunneke with the board. Outlet pass up ahead to Julian. And on the run, Hurd's going to lay it up and in. 4:45 to go, and it's 74-41. Here's a quick trigger. Three won't go. The rebound pulled down. Won't go on the follow from Dillon. And the outlet up ahead to Hurd. He's on the run again and lost control, but I think they're going to call Rutherford, or check it, Roberson for the foul. Coach Maneri, even with this team up by 33 points, still not happy with the shot selection on that trip up the floor.
I tell you, I'd probably just sit down, just hope we can get it over with without getting anybody hurt.
Free throw from Hurd is good. He's got one more to come. 75-41. Roberson's going to check out. Checking back in is John Ormiston. There's another senior going to get a few minutes on the floor here. And the second free throw from Hurd is good as well. And the lead is back out to 35 for Episcopal. This is a very good Episcopal basketball team here. Make no mistake about it, folks. Here is a rebound by Austin Robinson on the miss. Up ahead, Jamal Williams to Julian. Hurd thought about a three. Dishes instead. They want to go to Robinson. Tipped, but saved. And we work it under 4 minutes to go here in the ball game. Jamal Williams with the runner on the baseline. And he will lay it up and in for two, 78-41. Episcopal, two of their three losses this year have been to the Village School, another very good private school team here in the area. The other loss was in the HISD tournament back in December, and that was to Sterling. As you see, Wilkins on the run. Nice little runner and teardrop that goes down through, and he'll go to line for the plus one. Sam Suleiman check in. He wears zero on his uniform for the Knights. He's a senior that's going to get a couple of minutes here at the end of the ball game. Free throw is missed. Robinson saves it, though. Gets it to Ormiston, and he throws it away.
Back in for
So let's reset. Players on the floor as Austin Robinson checks out. We've got Hunneke and also Kendall Ramlal out there, and they're joined by Suleiman and Williams, Cameron Williams. He lost control but saves it. Dishes it out to Stuart Cartwright. Can't get it to go. And Ramlal with the follow won't go. Tried to put it back up, but he's hammered, and we've got, let's see, a jump ball called. And there's the fieriness of Coach Maneri. He thought that was a foul. He thought his team should be going to the line.
No blood, no foul.
Well, especially at this stage of the game, I would imagine the officials are
trying to get it over with.
Trying to get everybody in safe and sound. 3:18 to go as they inbound the ball. 78-43. Dribbled down by Suleiman, stolen away, and here come the Falcons on the run. Bringing it across the floor and across the timeline. It's William Belt, and we've got a whistle, and there's going to be a foul. Going to be called on Osuji. And double bonus time. And that's going to send, looks like, Cameron Williams to the line. Try and get on the scoreboard here.
Yep.
Cameron Mitchell, number 20 in the blue there, you see at the line, has checked in. '78-43, '79-43, and that draws a big cheer from the Episcopal student body section, who are standing just beyond the free throw line along the far stands. And the free throw number two takes it up to 80-43 here. Under 3 minutes to go in this one, almost a steal. Cravens in the corner, can't get it to go. Rebound is tipped and controlled by Hunneke. But he loses it. Osuji's got it, but can't get the point-blank shot to go. In the corner to Cravens for three. Won't go, and the rebound fought for. Put up by Belt, and he gets it to go. William Belt with his first bucket of the ballgame, 80-45. Knocked out of bounds by Craven. It'll be long to the Knights. Cameron Mitchell. Stuart Cartwright will inbound the ball. He's going to try to go back court, and he gets it to Suleiman, who will bring it up. Almost lost his dribble. Kincaid fans wanted a walk or a carry there. Instead, he keeps possession, gets it across to Cameron Williams. He'll back it out as we roll down to the two-minute mark. Williams with a nice little penetration through the paint, couldn't finish it off, and Osuji brings it up into the corner. Cravens, three, rattles out, will not go down. And that's kind of a microcosm of the way the night has gone.
You got a technical foul. I knew it was coming sooner or later on somebody.
Well, they call it on the bench, and
yeah, one of the coaches said so.
So Cartwright will go to the line. One of the assistant coaches for Scott Zimmerman just had about all he could stand.
Yeah.
First free throw won't go. The second one does. Cartwright gets one out of two at the line. Here's an outlet, and on the baseline, a feed to Hunneke, and he lays it off the glass for two out of the possession from the technical foul, and so it's 83-45, a minute and a half to go here. It's all over but the final score. Into the corner, there's a three from Bell. He's got five in the ball game now. Here all in the fourth quarter, 83-48, and there's a steal by Cravens. And he is going to be fouled, bumped by Cameron Mitchell.
The physical foul call on number 20, Cameron Mitchell, his first personal 10-team foul, double bonus in the second.
Cameron Mitchell picks up the foul, and Cravens kind of took one, I think, right on the bridge of the nose there. It's going to go to the line. Double bonus for both teams. I don't care what conference you play in, though, Coach. When you've got a mixture of athleticism on offense and tenacity on defense, that is a potent combination for any team. This team, I think they could probably play with a lot of schools in the area.
I tell you what, this is their 31st game and 28th win, and, you know, it shows why. But like you say, they're playing on both ends of the court. Aggressively offensively, aggressively defensively.
Both free throws are no good, and back the other way. Suleiman tries to skip step through traffic. It won't go, but the follow by Hunneke put back off the glass for two, and it's 85-48. Down to the final minute.
Hunneke is making the most of his minutes.
Ormiston dishes to Belt. Back goes Tsuji. Looks to penetrate. Puts up the runner. Won't go. He's going to draw a foul, though, and I think it's going to be on Cameron Williams. No, it's going to be called on 24 instead of 2. Stuart Cartwright picks up the personal. As, yep, he got by Cameron Williams. But Cartwright came over to try to help on defense and got him with the body. The free throw from Tsuji is good. Episcopal will go to 28-3 on the air, finish up the conference play at 7-0. Kincaid will drop to 20-8, 6-1 in the SPC, and there is a whistle and a foul. A little wild play on both ends of the floor. William Belt hits the deck, watch it again. He kind of cleared with the offhand there, but then Cartwright draws the foul in the paint.
Yeah, I'd like to get a pistol with my preseason shootout in September. You know, I put one on at North Shore Senior High at last weekend in September. You try to get about 16 teams.
Nice little tune-up for a lot of teams for the season.
Right. But with a bunch like he has, you know, they'll get a lot out of it. You know, playing against quite a few public schools.
Right. 85-51, under 20 seconds now. The clock rolls down to 10. And Episcopal up by 34 points will come away with the road win tonight, and the clock will wind down, and it'll be a victory for the visitors in blue. The Episcopal Knights, 85-51 is your final score tonight. We'll come back and put a wrap on it, try to visit with Coach Maneri and maybe a player as well when we come back on the postgame show here on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Are you a fan of Demoisier?
Demoisa who? Okay, you know you're smart. You just ordered a premium roast coffee and a savory sausage McMuffin for only a dollar each off McDonald's dollar menu at breakfast. So he has a certain je ne sais quoi.
Hey, sports fans. You've got to get to the Sports House. The Sports House, located at 2738 Gulf Freeway, features over 22,000 square feet of indoor air-conditioned sports fun with state-of-the-art athletic training packed into every inch of the place. Got big dreams? The Sports House offers comprehensive lesson packages and sports clinics for a wide range of sports, including baseball, softball, volleyball, basketball, and football. And if you're looking to fine-tune your game, we offer speed and agility training, too. And every Sports House lesson and clinic is overseen by a professional or collegiate athlete. You'll get instruction you can't find anywhere else. And Mom and Dad, we can host that special party for your young athlete in our party room. Call us today at 281-557-TEAM. The Sports House, again located at 2738 Gulf Freeway. Dream big, play hard, train smart. 281-558-57-TEAM. The Sports House.
You know why I love Walmart?
You got this at Walmart? No way. Way. Whew, I almost bought one of these at another store. No way. Way.
They have the same brand name TVs as the pricey electronics stores.
No way.
Way.
That's all you paid? No way. Way. So we got a great TV and we had money left over to save.
Get the best brands like Sony, Sharp, Samsung, and Vizio at the Walmart price. Save money. Live better. Walmart.
When it just can't wait, come to Texas Emergency Care Center, where a licensed, freestanding emergency room open 24 hours a day, every day. Whether it's a broken bone or chest pain, the doctors and staff at Texas Emergency Care Center specialize in emergency medicine. We're ready and waiting, so you don't have to. At Texas Emergency Care Center, you'll be seen in minutes. We're open 24/7 in Pearland and Cypress, opening this summer in Atascocita. Find us online at txercare.com.
Wake up to McDonald's Deluxe Breakfast Platter. Scrambled eggs, crispy bacon, fluffy hotcakes, new premium roast coffee, and more.
On the FoxSportsHouston.com postgame show for our game of the week tonight between the Episcopal Knights and the Kincaid Falcons, and a very good night for the road team tonight. Coach Kyle Maneri of Episcopal joins us, and Coach, from start to finish, your team just had the intensity on the defensive end, and shots were falling for you on the offensive side as well.
Yeah, it makes it a lot easier when we get some stops to get out and run a little bit with the ball, get some layups. It gets the juices flowing in the kids, gets their feeling good, so maybe they pop out, hit a couple of threes. But we did it rebounding and defensively. You know, I was proud of the kids for the energy. Still made a ton of mistakes, had a ton of turnovers, thought way too sloppy for Episcopal basketball. But we'll correct that stuff, and hopefully next game we'll get a lot better.
Well, if this was a little bit sloppy, we'd really love to see your team when they're clicking on all cylinders, because they look pretty good. A lot of turnovers for Kincaid kind of got you in a rhythm early, but even when they had looks at the basket, you were getting hands up in the passing lane.
Yeah, I mean, we every day it's defense first for us, rebounding second, offense is very last. So we pride ourselves on playing hard, trying to rotate. I was very disappointed in the amount of charges that we took. I thought we could have taken a ton tonight, and I thought we bailed out a bunch. But, again, it's good teaching points.
Well, 85-51 is the final score. Big contribution from a guy we're about to talk to over here to my right. Talk a little bit about Ken Williams and his performance tonight.
You know, just a special, special guy. He's a phenomenal scorer. I've been around a lot of different levels a long time. And he's got the knack. He just kind of knows he's crafty with the ball, knows how to draw fouls. He got a mid-range game, three-point shot game. And, you know, he's just dangerous with the ball. He's hard to guard. He got out early, got some easy layups, got a couple of threes going his way. And it just gets him in a rhythm early, and he's really hard to guard. That's why he's the city-leading scorer for the last two seasons.
Well, and now with the win tonight, you go into the playoffs now, the top seed. And really champions of the South Division. How big is that for you heading into the second season?
you know, I tell you what, everything is just the next game. So the next game's the most important. I'm happy we got the number one seed. I'm happy we got a league championship for our school and for our community. The fans were fantastic tonight. They deserve that. But, I mean, now it's three games. Doesn't matter. We got to go win them. We got to get that championship ring. I mean, that's the whole preacher. That's what we preach the whole season is about, the ring. So hopefully we can get Ken to play a little better defense coming up, and maybe we'll get some easier points.
Oh, we'll talk to him about that. Congratulations on the win, though.
Thank you.
Kyle Mineri, the head coach. And here he is, the man of the hour, the leading scorer in tonight's game, Ken Williams. And, Ken, great performance tonight. Talk about what you guys were anticipating coming in. You had to know the atmosphere here tonight was going to be electric on the road for you guys, but you came in, it looked like, with a lot of confidence.
We just played hard on defense. That's it. We worked and practiced hard every day, waiting for this game. It's a big rivalry. Us and St. John's, we just played hard, just hard. We won the game so bad. We got the number one seed. That's what we're looking for. Now we're just looking to get that ring.
You came in on the road. The crowd was at a high level coming into this one. You guys seemed to take them out pretty early, and I would imagine that had to be part of the strategy.
Coach just preaches defense, 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 defense. That's it. All we had to do was stop them on defense, and offense will come. Transition.
Talking about the transition, you did get, especially in the second and third quarters, a lot of easy baskets off of rebounds, and you were able to take it basically coast to coast a lot of times.
They weren't really getting back, so we had the opportunity to, like, go in transition, get easy buckets instead of, like, coming into like a half-court team, just get easy buckets and go transition.
Well, it was a great performance. You're the leading scorer in this game. We appreciate you stopping by. Congratulations on the win. Congratulations on the season.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Ken Williams, senior guard for the Episcopal Knights, and he is our player of the game in the game of the week here on FoxSportsHouston.com. When we come back, we'll put a wrap on tonight's game here from Melcher Gym on the campus of the Kincaid School on FoxSportsHouston.com.
Thinking of changing jobs, or you're an employer needing to hire personnel, then you need to talk with Metter Staffing Services. Metter Staffing has been in business for over four decades and is one of the largest staffing services in the Houston area, servicing a national market. Metter Staffing has specialists wanting to serve you in the areas of engineering, accounting, administrative support, industrial, IT, marketing, and many other job categories. They have seven locations to serve your staffing needs. Call 713-941-0616 and they can direct you to the office nearest you. Metter Staffing on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn.
Here at Melcher Gym, one final time on the evening here on FoxSportsHouston.com. Lonnie King and Joe Price putting a wrap on this one. Joe tried to talk to the coach and to Ken Williams about their offense tonight, and both of them only wanted to talk about defense, so that tells you where the mindset is for this team.
Oh, yeah, nobody wants to talk offense, but I guarantee you the Williams kid can play. He put up about 27 points tonight and had a real good shooting percentage. You know, Episcopal, I was really impressed with him.
Very impressive performance tonight. And I guess to sort of reinforce the point they were both making, and especially Coach Mineri, he feels like the defense will generate some offensive opportunities for him. And we saw that tonight.
Yeah, that's true. And, you know, that's probably the hardest thing to preach to kids nowadays is defense. And, I mean, if you can get them to buy in, you know, the offense is going to be there. But if you can get them to buy in on defense, sacrifice their bodies, take charges, hey, you're going to win quite a few games.
Well, now the Knights go into the playoffs, and there are two divisions in the SPC, a Division One and a Division Two, and the top eight teams from the North and South zones go into the Division One playoffs, and the bottom eight teams, or eight of the bottom nine teams, go into the Division II playoffs. This team in Episcopal needs three wins, and they're the SPC champs, and they look like solid picks right now.
Well, you know, you start the season off, it's all about the ring. You know, I mean, coaches preach it, kids think about it,
And like you say, they got three games to go. They get those three, they got it.
Well, that will remain to be seen for the Knights, and Kincaid may get them again somewhere down the road, and that will be seen as well. But for tonight, a big win on the road in a highly charged environment, let's say it that way, here at the Kincaid School. And our thanks to the folks here at Kincaid, T.J. Bath, the athletic director, Scott Zimmerman, the head coach, and all the folks here at Kincaid that made our visit a very pleasant one. We thank them, and we thank you for watching us. For Joe Bryce and for the entire crew that brought you this one, I'm Lonnie King. Thanks for joining us here on FoxSportsHouston.com's Game of the Week. We'll see you next week.